forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Today we celebrate Wednesday of the fifth week of Easter. Oh God, restore the love of innocence.
Direct the hearts of your servants toward yourself, that those you have set free from the darkness of unbelief may never stray from the light of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading comes from the Acts of the Apostles. Some who had come down from Judea were instructing the brothers, "Unless you are circumcised according to the Mosaic practice, you cannot be saved." Because there arose no little dissension and debate by Paul and Barnabas with them, it was decided that Paul, Barnabas, and some of the others should go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and presbyters about this question. They were sent on their journey by the church and passed through Phoenicia and Samaria, telling of the conversion of the Gentiles, and brought great joy to all the brethren. When they arrived in Jerusalem, they were welcomed by the church, as well as by the apostles and the presbyters, and they reported what God had done with them. But some from the party of the Pharisees who had become believers stood up and said, "It is necessary to circumcise them and direct them to observe the Mosaic law." But the apostles and martyrs met together to see about this matter. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our response, let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. I rejoice because they said to me, "We will go up to the house of the Lord." And now we set foot within your gates, O Jerusalem. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Jerusalem built as a city with compact unity. To it the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord, according to the decrees for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. In it are set up judgment seats, seats for the house of David. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. May the Lord open my heart and my lips to make worthy of this gospel. May the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia. Remain in me as I remain in you, says the Lord. For whoever remains in me will bear much fruit. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "I am the true vine, and my Father is a vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and everyone that does, he prunes so that it bears even more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said to his disciples, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. Remain in me as I remain in you." name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Does it ever happen that we should ever be happy about someone dying? I remember asking this question to an undertaker just to find out what his response would be. He said, well, most of the time, in the situations in which he comforted people who had lost someone, very few people are happy. Most people are quite saddened and distraught about losing someone who was close. And most people, even though they may not have been close to the individual, still are disappointed in the fact that they lost someone who they knew. Well, are there ever any times when we should be happy about someone's death? Well, he did say a couple of occasions. He says, for example, if a person faces a terrible tragedy, accident, or illness, their suffering can be so terrible that people are happy when they finally pass on because the suffering has come to an end. He also said there are instances in which it seems that someone who is really evil to the community, a serial killer, a terrorist, a criminal, or someone who is greedy and selfish, who has been a danger to the community, finally dies. There is relief. That person's passed on. They said also, it may happen when a person has lived beyond all expectation. Perhaps they suffered a handicap when they were born, or a mental disease, or some other serious disability. Instead of living 10 years through much suffering and struggle, they live 30 years, or instead of 30 years, 60 years, or instead of 60 years, 90 years. And when people see them pass on, they recognize the achievement that in every day they made, just by the very fact they committed themselves to life. They're happy to see that success that they achieve as they pass on. But there's one other group that people often find some solace when they die, and that's holy people who look forward to death with no fear, who talk about it all the time as if it's going to be a glorious event, and can't wait to see the missing, their deceased relatives and friends once again in the heavenly kingdom. That when those people die, people smile because they know they've received their heavenly reward. How do you look at death? Are you looking forward to it? Most of us don't like to see anything die. We don't like to see plants die. We don't like to see animals die. We certainly don't like to see other human beings die. So how can we take Christ's attitude about death? What will help us change our attitude? Well, perhaps we should recognize it's going to happen anyway. All of us are going to die. But reflect on Scripture that tells us that those who are faithful to God live on forever. In the words of the Bible, that can give us a brighter point of view. If we pray for the dead and keep them in our lives and stay connected with them so they can pray for us, that's another way we'll always think of death in a positive way. We prepare by living a good and holy life. We prepare for death in a very positive way. And I think especially for me, when reading about the people who've died and come back, that makes me believe, like in their words, which match your Scripture, that they look forward to dying again. They can't wait to get back to heaven. If we take this attitude, then we will be like Jesus. And when we look forward to death, it'll be a happy event for us. It'll be a happy event for those who see us die. The Lord has come to give us eternal life, to give us happiness in this life, and also the life to come. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In Christ Jesus, the risen one, we recognize the saving plan of God and come to believe in the power of God's redeeming love. With Easter faith, let us present our prayers to the God of mercy. With all Christian churches, that they may persevere in faith and bear witness to the unifying power of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. With every nation and people, that we may all rejoice in the blessings of peace and justice, let us pray to the Lord. with moms everywhere, with the Almighty Father, and we'll bless them with the grace to find great joy in their family life. Let us pray to the Lord to hear our prayer. With our whole parish community, that we may build up the spiritual temple of God in our midst, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our suffering sisters and brothers, especially the sick of our parish, that they may have the sorrow, their sorrow turned into lasting joy. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And with all who have died, especially Monsignor Joseph McGowan, that he may enjoy the fullness of life with all who pass on to Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. And for our own personal intentions, which we offer in silence. Let us pray to the Lord. Almighty God, we thank you for calling us to be a holy people. In Jesus Christ, our way, our truth, and our life. Hear the prayers we offer so that we may speak his words and do his works for the salvation of all. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you. Through the earth and work of human hands, it become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever.
Just 101, we come to share, and before you, Christ would humble himself to share our humanity.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you. Through the vine and work of human hands, it become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever.
Humble spirit, contrite heart, may be accepted by you, Lord. May our sacrifice, your sight this day, be pleasing to you, Lord God. For my iniquity. Cleanse me from all my sins.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept the sacrifice in our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to lord you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is a sacrificial lamb who dies no more. The lamb once slain lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Today we pray the second Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time as we trade, entered willingly into his passion, took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which you poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who've died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. Your mercy keep us free from sin and safe from all distress, as you wait the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who will reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. At this time, let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, through your death gave life to the world. Freeing by this your most holy body and blood from all my sins and from every evil, keep me always faithful to your commandments. Never let me depart from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter into my roof. Only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Let Christ keep us safe from eternal life. Of Christ, keep us safe for eternal life.
Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless us all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. The Mass is ended. May you have a wonderful week and a wonderful day. God bless you.